It's the NBA on 2K Sports. And our broadcast team tonight, Greg Anthony here to my left and Steve Smith to my right. And the Hall of Famer, David Aldridge, along the sideline. D.A., take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Julius Randle says of these Knicks, we're building something good here, and I'm glad to be a part of it. We have a collective purpose. Not another fan base in the league that can match what these Knicks fans will give us if we're taking care of our business. Guys, those fans have waited for a long time.
They have been patient for sure, David. Thank you. How about we check the numbers for Mitchell Robinson?
In the last five games, you can see the trend upwards for effective field goal percentage, and it shows you how confident he's playing right now.
And the starting group for the Grizzlies. Adams at center with Jackson next to him. Then it's Williams. Then it's Morant. And it's Bane in at the shooting guard position. And for the Knicks, in the forward positions, Barrett and Randle. Alec Burks is out there with Evan Fournier. And it's Noel in at the five spot. Two very athletic teams here, Greg. A game that's sure to produce a lot of highlights.
It makes me think of Stacey Ogden, one of the greatest athletes I ever played alongside.
Now here's Jackson. They count on his contributions, currently providing 16.5 points a game. Here's Williams. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
And the fireworks begin. Should be an amazing show tonight.
How good is it to see the first one go through the net?
Burks against Morant. Here's Randle. Some solid defense there from Jackson. The Grizzlies on offense. Morant looking around. And they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
And the work ethic of Morant, fantastic at keeping his focus on the task at hand.
And if you're wondering if Ja Morant lacks for confidence, well, look no further than his point guard moniker. This kid is fearless, and he's hungry, and he plays with that proverbial chip on his shoulder.
That's good from Morant. And Greg, you talk about the fearlessness for Morant, reminiscent of Allen Iverson, the way he throws his body all around.
I mean, get knocked down, get right back up. At the same time, at 6'3", he can add strength to that frame. I know that's the goal of his as he looks to absorb contact and dish out a little of his own.
Just five to shoot. Fournier for three. Can't hit that one. Now the Grizzlies take it the other way. First chance of the season for them to go up against this Knicks team. Adams the pass to Morant. Jackson a screen on Burks. Morant against Burks. Fires the three. And it's Morant missing. For the Knicks, it's been a slow start here. It's a five-point game. To the inside. Noel dishes to Burks. And the rejection by Jackson. Passes it to Bane. Some nice passing there by Memphis. The Grizzlies with another miss.
Uncontested look. Can't fault the shot selection. He's money from there.
Randle with the ball. 17 points in his last outing. Pass to Noel. Morant against Burks. New York needs to get off a shot.
Some scouts were surprised when Jackson's wingspan was measured over 7'5". That's a huge number, especially when you talk about contesting shots.
Over in the corner, Williams takes a three. And another miss by Memphis.
Defensively, it's hard to account for everything. They gambled off him, and it worked.
Outside Fournier, and it's Desmond Bane with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Memphis on defense. Now Burks. They look to him for part of their offensive attack. Right now he averages nearly 12 points a game. Shot clock at 2.
This is what Steven Adams is known for. A fantastic defensive player with terrific instincts.
Morant passes to Jackson. Back to Morant. From 12 feet out, it's rebounded by New York. They want to keep it rolling here following the win against Dallas.
I like their aggressiveness in that one. No one's going to give you anything. You've got to go out and take it.
Majority of the night, they were in attack mode. Tremendous effort all the way around.
Fournier's shot is off. And the Grizzlies leading by 5. Williams in the post. He's covered by Noel. Morant kicks to Williams. Pass to Jackson. And that's out of bounds. Memphis will retain possession.
In a moment now to see some numbers for Randall. He's averaging about 19 points per, 10 rebounds, and 5 assists. To have a scorer like him consistently deliver you points makes such a big difference for a team.
Because he gives you someone to build your offense around. You can count on his nightly production.
Mitchell Robinson's checked in for New York. And Memphis also making a switch. Kyle Anderson, he's checked in for Williams. Here's Bane. And another miss by Memphis.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Morant outside. Randall grabs the board.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Fournier dishes to Burks. Back to Fournier. Shot clock reset for the Knicks. Count it, good.
How about the purpose with which he's crashing the backboards right now? Some hard-earned second-chance points.
Burks against Morant. Adams with the screen on Burks. Adams trying to free himself up, and it's Morant missing. Knicks trail by 3. And he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
What a beautiful look. Randall continues to round out his game in the prime of his career.
Memphis has gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. It's Anderson with the drive. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Allowing any room to operate, you know he's going to be aggressive.
Randall, a screen on Morant. There's the pass to Randall. Rejection by Jackson. Morant outside. Adams with the screen on Burks. With some arc. Offensive rebound. And the shot goes in.
Can't teach size and strength. Once Adams gets position, you're not rooting him out of there.
And the Knicks decide to take their first timeout here.
And the intensity Steven Adams brings onto the court with him is obvious. He doesn't let the game come to him. He wants to dictate tempo.
And Greg, that's a quality that served him well. He had a lot to prove when he came into this league. He had to be assertive early on. That attitude has never left him. He still is an intimidator.
And a new group in for the Knicks. Taj Gibson's checked in for Randall. Reddish comes in for Barrett. Emmanuel Quickly, he's checked in for Evan Fournier. And it's Kemba Walker in for Alec Burks. Memphis also making some changes. Conchar's checked in for Kyle Anderson. De'Anthony Melton comes in for Bane. And Jones subbed in for John Morant. Robinson finds Gibson. Now, here's Quickly. Defense is right there. And a wide open look for Walker. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
Well, that basket by Walker, it shows you he's versatile at that point guard position, able to score off the pass.
Memphis leading. Melton feeling it out a bit. Passes to Concho. Outside Jackson. Robinson against Adams. Shot clock at 6. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
If you give him an inch of space, he's going to make you pay.
.115 left to play in the first. And here is Quickly. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. Walker's shot is off. Memphis leading by 4. Adams outside. Inside. That shot, no good. The Knicks go the other way with it. Quickly the pass to Walker. Here's Reddish. New York moving the ball around. Walker against Jones. Again, the miss by Walker. Memphis has gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And out of bounds as the Knicks gain possession. And the Grizzlies with some changes. Tillman, he's checked in for Adams. And it's Brandon Clark in for Jackson. And so it's Walker with it, who brings it up for the Knicks. Trailing by 4. Shot from the top of the key. Basket counts. Walker's got 5 points so far.
And the pick and roll, so effective when the ball's in Walker's hands. You can count on him to make the right read almost every time.
And a closely contested grit and grind first quarter comes to a close. Memphis out in front. They lead by 2. And we'll be back with you for the start of the second quarter when we return. And one of the better young two-way big men in the NBA, Jaren Jackson. He talked about how his defensive responsibilities grow.
Probably be more of a backline help, talk more, give more help for the rotations because, you know, depending on what team you play, there's a lot of specific things you got to do to guard a certain player.
Well, with his 7'4 wingspan, Jackson has all the tools to be an elite rim protector.
But advanced understanding of positioning. His father was an NBA player, so he's been taught the game from a young age.
And some good action in the books as we get back to the game that's been pretty close here so far. And taking a look at the Grizzlies' performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
Why take jump shots when you can get your points at the rim?
Especially at the start. You want to get something positive going and establish your rhythm.
Julius Randle is out there with Reddish. Then it's Barrett. Then it's Noel. And it's Walker in at the 1. That's the 5 for New York right now. Now here's Reddish. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Randle with a screen for Barrett to the left side wing. Here's Walker. No good. That would have tied it. Grizzlies have gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second quarter. Jones the pass to Tillman. Outside, Jones. And Greg, you made your money on the defensive end. What was the toughest kind of player to defend? A one-on-one guy or a constant movement type of player?
I've always will say that it's harder to guard movement. You know, as a defender, you drill a lot about guarding the basketball. But when a guy is great without it, man, that is the hardest job you can have defensively.
That ties it up. Randle's got his first 2 points of the night.
A high percentage shooter inside. That's exactly where you want to get Randle the ball.
Backcourt violation.
Not watching the line there. That'll be a backcourt violation. Fournier is checked in for Reddish. Williams, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. Morant comes in for Jones. Walker against Morant. Walker's shot is off. And for Memphis, they're shooting just 28%. They are offensively out of whack and out of step with each other at this point. Anderson, a screen on Walker. Morant kicks to Anderson. 5 on the clock. Williams sets a screen for Anderson. Into the lane. And it's Noel with the rebound. The Knicks have gotten only one of their first 4 shots in the second quarter to drop. And again, it's the Knicks missing.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Morant passes to Williams. Out left to the wing. He feeds it to Morant. Here's Bane. Nice D from Fournier. The Knicks shooting a putrid 25% from the field. Poor shot selection all around. And over his 4 years at TCU, Desmond Bane shooting 43% from long range. And Steve, he has not slowed down in the NBA.
The Grizzlies, can you believe, took him with the final pick of the first round in 2020. That's great value, getting a floor spacer with size that late. And for his offense, this has just been a brutal period.
Walker against Morant. It drops for his second made shot of this game. An unimpressive 2-7, though.
The quickness of Ja Morant is what makes his drives deadly. Where did he go?
New York trailing. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, Fournier passes to Walker. New York moving the ball around. Barrett wide open. He fires. Traps in the tray. Barrett's got the lead up to 1 now for the Knicks. Here's Morant. He's coming off a 16-point game against Minnesota. Floats one, and the rejection by Noel. Barrett, the pass to Walker. Out to the right wing. The 3, and it's Walker again missing.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing.
And it also shows you how difficult this game is. He's just a little bit off, but it can result in missing everything.
And that one's good, Morant.
Look how Ja just glides through the contact. He's such a nimble player.
New York's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
and a new group in for the Knicks. Mitchell Robinson's checked in for Nerlens Noel. Gibson comes in for Randall. Manuel Quickly, he's checked in for Barrett. And it's Burks in for Kemba Walker. Memphis also making some changes. Jaren Jackson, he's checked in for Tillman. And it's De'Anthony Melton in for Bane. Outside Robinson, pass to Burks. Fournier in the corner. Gibson setting the pick for Fournier. Just five to shoot. So the wing on the left. And Gibson wide open. He shoots. That one wide left. Morant outside. Pass to Williams. He blocked it and deflects off the backboard. The pass to Fournier. Burks on the wing. He's guarded by Williams. Burks kicks to Fournier. And again, it's the Knicks missing. And here's Morant. He'll bring it up for Memphis. They've only allowed 5 points in the quarter.
The playmaking ability of Kyle Anderson combines great floor vision with his height and feel.
Knicks trail by three. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Pass to Burks. Back to Robinson. Gibson passes to Burks. From deep. It's rebounded by Memphis. They're coming off that win against Minnesota.
Yeah, and the focus was to get stops. All game, they were right up on shooters, and that led to some big-time rejections.
This was their game plan going in. Make shooters uncomfortable by challenging every possible shot.
And Fournier kicks to Quickly. Gibson setting the pick for Quickly. Trying to end the drought. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good. And the Knicks making a change here. Reddish is checked in. Memphis also making some changes. Steven Adams, he's checked in for Anderson. Conchar comes in for Williams. And Jones subbed in for John Morant. And Quickly drops them both.
Money from the stripe. He does a great job night in and night out.
Jones against Burks. Adams with the screen on Burks. Here's Jackson. Up and in. Off to an efficient start. 2 for 3 from the field.
What you know you love about Jaren Jackson is the length, the instincts. He has a natural feel for the game.
Here's Quickly. And that one is off. Good work defensively by Jones. 41 seconds left in the first half. And Adams with the slam.
You just can't let Adams get this deep in the paint, because when he does, he's focused on slamming it down.
Now, here's Quickly. He's guarded by Melton. Now, here's Quickly. Pass to Reddish. Fires for three, and Mitchell Robinson is going to pick up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. A fantastic mobile one block. This one deserves another look.
Sharp instincts on D there. Just timing when to rise up and swat that one away.
And the Grizzlies leading by 5. Jones looking for an opening. Pass to Jackson. And it's blocked. What a play as he just snatches the shot out of midair. And that's it for the first half of action. What's been a very close game here. Grizzlies lead by 5. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Here with Tom Thibodeau. Coach, I saw you getting into your team. What's been the problem?
We're playing a low-energy game. We got to get into the ball. Our ball pressure has to be a lot better. Got to challenge shots, so we're playing low energy on offense.
I sense the theme. Energy seems to be a problem. Back to you guys.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
Welcome, everybody. The story tonight has been a solid showing through the first half for the Memphis Grizzlies.
They put a big effort in the rebounding battle, working to corral every miss. That's the hustle you love to see. If they can maintain this approach, it'll give them the edge in other areas of the game.
And now that we're a ways into the season, here's how the standings look out west.
Taking a look at Memphis. They've been awesome so far this year. That was expected from the good analysts who know what they're talking about. We've got one on this panel, and it's called Shaq O'Neal. You don't know about the other two.
That is more than enough of us. Let's send you back to the game, Kevin Harlan and crew, with the second half.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Barrett with the ball. They count on his contributions, currently providing 16.5 points a game. So on the floor for Memphis. Adams at center with Jackson next to him. Then there's Ja Morant. Then it's Williams. And it's Bane in at the two guard. Barrett, no good. Memphis leading by 5. Nobody near Williams. No good on the 3. Jackson against Burks. He dishes it to Barrett. It's Fournier on the wing. And he can be counted on to put some points on the board every night. He's averaging right around 13.5 points a game. And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Memphis Grizzlies. 5-point lead, the biggest of the game. Now the pass to Jackson. Shoots from 12. And it's Noel with the rebound. Noel's got 5 rebounds tonight. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure. And one thing that separates Randle from other guys, his size, that spin move. He can do it off the drive, in the post, now going either direction.
And whirling around the floor, Greg, is there anyone Randle reminds you of?
I mean, they're different players, but Hakeem Olajuwon had an unbelievable spin move. Takes a lot of body control, especially for taller guys. But when you do it well, man, it is tough to stop.
The first one falls.
When it comes to addressing his weaknesses, the right hand, the range, Randle has put in the work.
That one falls, so he hits both of them. Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. Adams with the screen on Burks. Morant drives in over Burks. The Grizzlies with another miss. Knicks trail by 3. Fournier passes to Burks. The dish to Barrett. Some nice passing by New York here. To the left wing. 6 to shoot. From 12 feet out. Randle no good.
The struggle is real. He's been way off with his shot all evening long.
Williams for 3. Drills the 3-pointer. Williams has got 5 now.
How about that move? You'll see very few players able to pull off. Just sensational stuff.
To the inside. It's stolen by Adams. It's Williams with the drive. It's tipped.
It's amazing. All night he's been out of sync on the offensive end, yet they continue to lead.
Fournier finds Noel. Now Burks. Randall with a screen for Burks. Over Jackson. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That's on Jaren Jackson.
He's a regular at the free throw line. Burks knows how to put the onus on the officials.
New York shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game. Free throw good, Burks.
The former University of Colorado alumni Burks, a solid two guard who can really light it up.
Clark, he's checked in for Memphis. Anderson comes in for Williams. And Burks hits two free throws. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Now Morant. He has seven. And the call will be against Fournier. That's his first foul. Kemba Walker's checked in for the Knicks. And Memphis also making a switch. Tillman's checked in. Clark outside. Lock at six. It's stolen by Randall. Outside Fournier. That's in. Coming off an assist from Randall. Fournier's got five.
Attacking the defense with the pass. Don't need to be a hero.
Here's Bane. It's rebounded by New York. Noel's got six rebounds now in the game. Passes it to Randall. For the lead, Fournier trying to break loose. And again, New York with the triple.
You just can't give him that shot anymore. Julius is now comfortable from distance.
Morant against Walker. Clark outside. Here's Bane. No points in the game hit for him. Just five on the clock. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. They grab their own miss. Good on the bucket.
And all of his athleticism on display there. Clark's work ethic makes him lethal on that offensive backboard.
Now here's Randall. He's got seven. Takes the 13-footer. It's Clark with the rebound. Clark's got his fourth rebound in this one. Here's Morant. And he finishes nicely on the layup. And it's 9 points for John Morant.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
The Knicks have gone 2 of 6 from the field here in the third. Pass to Noel. Kicks to Walker. It's Fournier on the wing. Five to shoot. Takes it from 10. He drains it as the shot clock ticks down. Fournier's got it all tied up now for New York.
Nice job getting inside for the layup. Got the D thinking. Jump shot. Gave a little pump fake. And then off to the races.
and new group in for the Knicks. Mitchell Robinson's checked in for Noel. Gibson comes in for Randall. Radish, he's checked in for RJ Barrett. And quickly in for Evan Fournier. The Grizzlies also changing it up. Conchar's checked in for Tillman. De'Anthony Melton comes in for Bane. And Tyus Jones subbed in for John Morant. Grizzlies have gone a lackluster 3 of 9 from the field since halftime. Jones kicks to Melton. It's not going to go for him. And New York will come the other way. And after this game wraps up, they're off to Atlanta where they'll take on the Hawks. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip. Here's Walker. Here's Robinson. Another shot, and it's good on the layup. Robinson's got the lead up to 2 now for the Knicks.
And that's a lesson for the D. Fight harder on the glass.
Reason why, lack of focus, lack of communication, which led to second chance points.
Now here's Anderson. A look at his stats. He averages a bit over 8 points a game. Walker with it. Guarded now by Anderson. Back to Walker. Pass to Reddish. It's blocked.
Well, this is where measurements don't tell the whole story. Clark is a tremendous shot blocker despite having an average wingspan.
Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
Yeah, quick thinking pays off big. What a block.
Off the inbound pass. The kick out to Walker. Gibson setting a pick for Reddish. Ball's knocked loose. Shot clock at 3. Back to Walker from downtown.
I'll tell you what, he's been off target all night, and his teammates have had to rally.
And defensively, no matter the size of the man he's guarding, Walker really puts up a fight.
Some smaller guards pretend to battle, but Walker will bang with you, try to front you, pull on your jersey, whatever it takes. He backs down from no one.
Now here's Walker. Brandon Clark missing his last shot. Robinson passes to Quickly. He kicks to Reddish. And he banks in the layup. Reddish has got his first basket.
We saw a lot of this from Cam in college. He seems most comfortable creating off the bounce.
Melton passes to Clark. Back to Melton. They need this one, and Gibson sends it back.
Nice defense from Taj, one of the best rim protectors in this league.
Here's Conchar, and he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Here's a look at some stats for Jones. How's the last month of basketball been for him? He's averaging 10 points a game, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. Yeah, he's been making the right decisions and letting the game come to him. Solid play all around.
He's not trying to take over necessarily.
Shoot 2.
He's just taking what the defense allows and contributing to the calls.
That one is off.
Well, probably a little draft in the arena tonight. He's the last guy you expect to miss the mark by that one.
Absolutely. Julius Randle's checked in for the Knicks. Alec Burks comes in for Kemba Walker. Memphis also making some changes. Adams comes in for Clark. And it's Jackson in for Anderson. He hits the second from the line. So here's Burks. 41 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. The pass to Quickly. And powered down the jam.
Never a bad idea to run the old pick play.
You're right. And if it produces a slam like that, you'll probably see more of them.
Especially if the defense is going to allow you to do it. Have to switch on that play.
Here's Melton. The Knicks making the shot. Robinson with the block. to the middle. Low block shot on the way. No good off the back of the rim.
And when you can't get anything to fall, it definitely gets in your head.
And his rhythm, it's been way off. The goal now might be to get him something easy at the rim so he can just see the ball go in through the net, and that helps.
And we've reached the end of the third. New York ahead, up by five. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feat.
Fundamental basketball. Keep your eyes up. Keep the ball moving. You're going to keep the defense on its heels.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. Sharing the wing spots, Fournier and Barrett. Randall and Robinson make up the inside pair. And it's Burks in at the point. That's the five for New York right now. Now here's Jackson over Randall. Jackson misses. Here's Burks. It's hauled in by Adams.
He looked just a little out of rhythm. He's still trying to establish consistency from there.
Williams scanning the floor for the three. The Knicks pull it in. Robinson's got six rebounds here tonight. Passes it to Burks. Here's Randall, guarded by Jackson. Outside Fournier. Back to Randall. Shot clock at six. Fournier trying to break loose. Randall no good.
So frustrating when you can't get anything to go down as you're trying to help your team finish the job.
New York leading by five. Fournier finds Randall. Now here's Burks. Offline with his three.
Can you believe it? He's missed every shot he's taken. Yet this team still continues to hold the lead.
Jackson setting the pick here for Morant. Randall grabs the board. Randall's got rebound number nine now. What an effort here tonight. Pass to Burks. Over to the left wing. Fades back. And Mitchell Robinson is going to pick up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Noel's checked in for Mitchell Robinson. Anderson, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Hey, Kevin. Well, Taylor Jenkins just reviewed his plan with his team. He wants them to work for more easy baskets in transition. He said, the moment we take possession of the ball, I want us to attack. If there's nothing there, then you can pull it back out and run the offense. Kevin?
All right, David, thanks. It's Morant in the corner. Outside Williams. It's rebounded by New York.
He's doing what he can to help them cut into this lead. His shot just isn't quite there tonight.
And the rejection by Jackson. On the wing, Williams. He's defended by Randall. Williams kicks to Morant. Anderson passes to Morant. Williams for three. The kick out to Anderson. Jackson setting the pick here for Anderson. Goes back up. The Knicks pull it in. Noel's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. And it's Barrett penetrating. Makes it off the glass. Barrett's got the lead up to 7 now for the Knicks.
And buckets like that have been hard to come by. Not the most exciting game. Both sides look way off in terms of their shooting.
You have to give credit to the defenses. Protecting the rim, closing out hard. This one's been a grind.
And it's good, 2 points.
A high percentage look for Kyle. Has the size and length to be a factor inside.
Barrett dishes to Burks. And there's the feed to Noel. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. Williams inside. Barrett covering. Burks against Morant. Pass to Bane. Jackson, a screen on Fournier. Here's Bane. And the rejection by Noel. And here's the fast break. Burks kicks to Noel. Burks, the pass to Barrett. From past the arc, Ja Morant grabs the rebound. Morant's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. And there's the pass to Bane. Out to Morant. Looking to get back on track here. And finished off by Morant.
What body control from Morant. Able to take the hit and power through it all.
So here's Burks. Outside Fournier. Randle outside for 3. Knocks it loose.
The thing is, you want to do everything you can to help your team. And sometimes you just try to do too much.
Shot's good by Williams. So here's Burks. Fournier sets the pick for Burks. Outside Fournier. Misses the 3. And it's Anderson with the ball for Memphis. Passes it to Jackson. Back to Morant. To take the lead. It's good. And the Grizzlies lead by 1.
Challenging the heart of the defense. Ja Morant can beat you with the pass or the shot.
New York's gone ice cold from 3-point land, 0-4 since the start of the final quarter. Steven Adams is checked in for Kyle Anderson. .158 left to play in the final quarter. Burks the pass to Fournier. Randle with a screen for Fournier. And the rejection by Jackson. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Jackson. Down to five on the shot clock. On its way from Burks for two. No good, unable to end this run.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Williams inside the line, and the Grizzlies check on two more. Knicks trail by three. Handle outside. Kicks it to Burks. That's in, coming off an assist from Randle. Randle's got three assists in the game. 1:19 left in the fourth quarter. Morant against Burks. Morant left side. Off the left rim and out. New York's gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 3-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. Now here's Burks. Fournier with the screen on Morant. Here's Burks. Grizzlies with the rebound.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Here's Morant. That shot is off. Now the Knicks take it the other way. Burks on the wing. Fournier finds Randle. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
Coming out of halftime, he wanted to start strong, yet the opposite happened.
16 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Morant passes to Adams, 11 feet away. It's good!
Throwing his weight around in the painted area, Steven Adams doing damage.
And so it's New York with it. Outside Fournier. So a close game sees Memphis take this one. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As New Balance presents our player of the game, Jaren Jackson.